चलो कना ऑटोनॉमिक नर्वस सिस्टम टॉपिक इधर 1-2 नंबर नहीं सर इधर हाँ अभी अच्छा थैंक यू आई एम डॉक्टर आजी लट्टी प्रोफेसर ऑफ फिजियोलॉजी गोइंग टू टेक ए क्लास ऑन ऑटोनॉमिक नर्वस सिस्टम ऑटोनॉमिक नर्वस सिस्टम is primarily concerned with the regulation of visceral or vegetative functions of the body. It's also called as vegetative or involuntary nervous system. The divisions of autonomic nervous system. So the autonomic nervous system is primarily concerned with the regulation of visceral or vegetative functions of the body. So it's also called as vegetative or involuntary nervous system. It is divided into two topics. One is called sympathetic division and second is called parasympathetic division. So what is sympathetic division? It is divided into two. The sympathetic division has got sympathetic ganglia. They divided into three groups: paravertebral group or sympathetic chain, prevertebral group or collateral ganglia, terminal or peripheral ganglia. So sympathetic ganglia are divided into three: paravertebral or sympathetic chain ganglia, second prevertebral or collateral ganglia, third terminal or peripheral ganglia. So what are the paravertebral contains of two. One is called cervical ganglia, thoracic ganglia, lumbar ganglia, and sacral ganglia. So the sympathetic chain is divided cervical ganglia, thoracic ganglia, lumbar ganglia, and sacral ganglia. The cervical ganglia, there are 8 cervical ganglia which are arranged in the 3 groups. The superior cervical ganglia is formed by the fusion of upper 4 cervical ganglia. It is the largest ganglia of the autonomic nervous system. It receives preganglion fibers from the first thoracic spinal segment T1 by a white ramoid. The postganglion fibers from the ganglion supply the blood vessels, glands, etc. The superior cervical ganglia also sends some fibers to heart through the superior cervical, sympathetic nerve, and cardiac plexus. Coming to the middle cervical ganglia, it is formed by the 5th and 6th cervical ganglia. It's formed by the 5th and 6th cervical ganglia. The preganglionic fibers arise from the T1 segment. The postganglionic fibers are here by supply of sweat glands, thyroid gland, and parathyroid gland. It also sends fibers to the heart via middle cervical, sympathetic nerve, and cardiac plexus. Inferior cervical ganglia. This ganglion is formed by the fusion of 7th and 8th cervical ganglia. First thoracic ganglion fuses with the inferior cervical ganglion, forming a stellate ganglion. It receives, first thoracic ganglion fuses with the inferior cervical ganglion, forming a stellate ganglion. It receives the preganglionic fibers from T1 segment. It sends postganglionic fibers to the heart through inferior cervical sympathetic and cardiac plexus. The postganglionic fibers also arise from the plexus around the subclavian artery and its branches. Second, thoracic ganglia. There are 12 thoracic ganglia on each side, and these ganglia are evenly spaced. The thoracic ganglia receive the preganglion fibers from thoracic segments of spinal cord. The postganglion fibers from thoracic ganglia are distributed to the visceral organs in the thorax and the abdomen. Lumbar ganglia, there are 5 lumbar ganglia. The preganglionic fibers for these ganglia arise from the first and second lumbar spidal. Segments L1 and L2 and reach the lumbar ganglia. From here, the fibers extend down to the sacral ganglia also. The post-ganglion fibers from these ganglia supply the abdominal and pelvic organs. Sacral ganglia, there are 5 sacral ganglia from S1, S2, S3, S4, S5 which receive the preganglion fibers from L1 and L2 segments. Postganglion fibers from sacral ganglia innervate the blood vessels and sweat glands in the lower limbs. Below the sacral level, the 2 sympathetic trunks converge and fuse upon the anterior surface of the coccyx on form a terminal swelling. This terminal swelling is known as coccygeal ganglion. The unpaired coccygeal ganglion is also called as ganglion impar. It receives the preganglion fibers from L1 and L2 segments. The postganglion fibers from here and distributed to the abdominal viscera and pelvic region. Prevertebral collateral ganglia are situated in the thorax and abdomen and pelvis in relation to the aorta and its branches. The prevertebral ganglia or ciliac ganglia, prevertebral or ciliac ganglia, superior mesenteric ganglion, inferior mesenteric ganglion. The prevertebral ganglia receive the preganglionic fibers from T5 to L2 segments. The postganglionic fibers from these ganglia supply the visceral organs of thorax, abdomen and pelvis. Ganglia, sympathoadrenergic system is a functional and phylogenetic unit that includes sympathetic division and adrenal medulla. Adrenal medulla is a modified sympathetic ganglion since the adrenal medulla and the sympathetic division develop from the same neural crest. Their secretions and functions are almost the same. Any increase in the sympathetic activity increases the secretion of catecholamines from adrenal medulla. The parasympathetic division, otherwise called as craniosacral flow, the terminal ganglia which are also supplying the heart, bronchus, urinary bladder, sympathoadrenergic system includes both sympathetic and adrenal medulla. Parasympathetic division, the parasympathetic division, otherwise called as craniosacral flow, because of the fibers of the division of the rise from the brain and sacral segments of spinal cord, the cranial portion of parasympathetic division is brainstem innervates the blood vessels of the head and neck and many thoracoabdominal visceral organs. The sacral portion in the sacral segments of the spinal cord innervates the smooth muscles forming the walls of the viscera and the glands such as large intestine, liver, spleen, kidneys, bladder, genitalia, etc. The cranial nerves of parasympathetic division are oculomotor nerve, third cranial nerve, second is facial nerve, third is grasopharyngeal nerve, ninth cranial nerve, fourth is vagus, tenth cranial nerve. There are 4 cranial nerves which are parasympathetic division. One is called oculomotor nerve, third cranial nerve. The second is called facial or 7th cranial nerve. Third is glossopharyngeal or 9th cranial nerve. And fourth is vagus nerve. The fibers of sacral flow arise from the sacral to 4th S2 S4 segment spinal cord. Thus, the preganglion fibers of parasympathetic division arise from the neurons situated at 3 different levels: tectal or midbrain level, 3rd cranial nerve, bulbar level or bulbar outflow, sacral outflow. The preganglionic fibers are longer. The fibers of sacral outflow arise from S2 S4 segments of spinal cord. Thus, the preganglionic fibers of the parasympathetic division arise from the neurons situated at a three different levels. Tectal or midbrain level, third cranial nerve, bulbar level, 7th, 9th, 10th cranial nerve, sacral outflow, sacral nerves. See, the bulbar flow, preganglion fibers arise from the 7th cranial nerve, which arise from the nuclei present in the medulla oblongata. Fibers of the 7th cranial nerve supply the second lacrimal, nasal, sublingual glands. The preganglionic fibers from nerve ganglion and subaxial ganglion. Postganglionic fibers from the spinopterygium ganglion supply lacrimal and nasal glands. The postganglionic fibers of submaxillary gland supply sublingual and subaxial glands. Fibers of 9th cranial nerve preganglionic fibers of synapse and postganglionic fibers supply the parotid gland. So, the fibers of 10th cranial nerve supply visceral organs of the body. The preganglionic fibers terminate in the ganglia, which are situated near the organs. The postganglionic fibers from the ganglia supply the organs. Vagus nerve supplies almost all the organs in the thorax and abdomen. Coming to sacral outflow, this is a diagram showing the where it supplies the sympathetic flow, ciliary muscles in the eye, relaxation and contraction, pupil shows sympathetic dilatation, whereas parasympathetic constriction, lacrimal glands decrease in the secretion, parasympathetic increase in secretion, salivary secretion decrease in secretion by sympathetic, parasympathetic, gastrointestinal motility inhibits, accelerate by parasympathetic, secretion decreases by sympathetic, secretion increases by parasympathetic, sphincters constriction by sympathetic, sphincters relaxation by parasympathetic, smooth muscles relaxation, smooth muscles contraction by parasympathetic, relaxation contraction by parasympathetic, urinary bladder detrusor muscle relaxation by sympathetic, contraction by parasympathetic, internal sphincter constriction relaxation by parasympathetic, glands increase secretion, and no heart rate and force increase by sympathetic, second muscle blood vessels by parasympathetic diffusion, controls dilatation and constriction by parasympathetic. So sympathetic fibers coming to the neurotransmitters of ANS. The sympathetic fibers are preganglionic fibers. They secrete acetylcholine. Postganglionic fibers, nonadrenergic fibers, noradrenaline. Postganglionic cholinergic fibers, acetylcholine. Postganglionic sympathetic cholinergic nerve supplying to sweat glands and blood vessels in the heart and skeletal muscle. They are also producing acetylcholine. The parasympathetic fibers, preganglionic fibers of acetylcholine and postganglionic fibers, acetylcholine utilizes the nicotinic receptors. Similar found the postganglionic nerves utilizes the muscarinic receptors. The muscarinic receptors